Hi everyone, welcome back to another gameplay of Grid 2. Let's continue with Career Mode Very Hard. This is episode 2 of season 4. And I apologize for the last video, it was very long. But yeah, these events now in this season have a lot of rounds together. And so you just participate Alex. In a single event and today. You end up you can do that, give it your best. Like having multiple races. And so yeah, the video was quite long for that reason. Now here are the difficulty that I will show at the beginning and the damage. So let's just continue here with the events. So there is a new Chrome event. Seems let's do now two short entrance. Yeah, let's do an endurance one, why not? And okay, so now in this part at least of the season, we start using this very weird not weird but very different cars. Now these cars drive very beautifully because they are super gripping cars, so you really can take the turns fast, and these cars are gonna like just follow, and so they feel very nice to drive. But normally you will not really use these cars in a lot of events. So you will almost never drift with these cars, but you can really like grip and go fast and still be able to grip from outside or from here. I keep on having this guy in front of me just moving left, right, and I can't overtake him, so I need to take some drastic measures if anything like okay, fine. And here with these cars, really the one that tries to do the turn fastest is the one that succeeds, because with these cars really you can go crazy fast in turns without really losing the without losing the car. Okay, here finally I cleared out these lower guys. So now I can focus on my style and I'm driving. You can see that I'm still drifting, but it only like you can do it only when you go very fast and you just brake and turn. Otherwise you're gonna just rip and you're gonna just turn properly. These cars compared like, to every other car, they feel a lot more like Formula 1 style. You can also hear like the engine, it sounds almost like electrical. Now this guy in front of me just braked and it like moved, and yeah, that wasn't very pleasant. Definitely the earlier I can just stop the drift, the better it is, because you can really exploit this car mechanics in gripping and still keeping a high speed. So
4 minutes left.
Probably just here I'm gonna just drift. And compared to the other guys, you can see we're already lapping are we lapping it, or it was there from the beginning? It seems like it was there from the beginning, because I'm in third position. I didn't see it before, so maybe I made a mistake. Wow, thank you. Nope. Now here I wanted to use handbrake, but that didn't work as I wanted. Okay. I didn't want the other guy to push me again into the wall.
You just put in the fastest lap.
Okay. Normally these cars right here, so the Caltrum is like the fastest in this feature. And yeah, that's V1. So I'll take it.
left.
The other guy is trying to fight back. There he had to break because it was a wall. And I purposely pushed him into the wall. So I had to break. And now how much time is left? 2 minutes and a half. So that's definitely a lot of time. I lost a ton of time to that turn there. It seems that like in this game the cars that crash like from behind are the ones that always get their aerodynamics bad, and the cars that are back are always gonna lose their control.
2 minutes to go.
So you keep the advantage here a little bit of it, but definitely I could go a lot faster than what I'm going, just not pushing too much of the limits. But I feel like with this car I could push like crazy. I don't have any more flashbacks, so I don't wanna. Oh, I had to go left. I couldn't go right there. It was too late to go right. Yeah, almost there, lost control. One minute and 20. Definitely drifting is not really suiting this car. You can see how much the other guys just gained on me. Seconds. Yeah, I'm gonna have to dive bomb here in the inside, trying to overtake him like in this turn right here. Yeah, sorry about that, buddy, but I wanna win. Yeah, that was quite close, if I have to say anything. Yeah, I knew I had to dive bomb there in the beginning at the turn to keep the lead. Okay, so that's the event here completed. Alright, so now I'm gonna continue with another event from the WSR, and you can see how much time it took just to complete this single event.
Promo events always offer the driver something new.
Let's do now
a challenge, then try it out.
Yeah, let's just go in order here. Let's do this face-off series. This is one versus one. I'm gonna use the Chevrolet. Feels quite nice to drive. One versus one here. Okay, this circuit is like quite narrow, but then it opens up because like you're going to like a highway, and then you go back to like a pretty narrow part of the circuit. So bad, so I'm gonna crash like that. 90. The top speed here. Definitely going way past that. Yeah, this is a part of the track you need to be very, very careful, because here it's very easy to like lose control of the car because you're going such high speeds that it's difficult to break and not lose control. Oh, yeah, I knew I was already bad here because I didn't do it properly. I try to keep an eye on the minimap, but the turns here are quite fast, one after the other, that I can't really look at it a lot of times. It's quite narrow, the next one. Oh. That was almost bad, almost, at the end of the day, worked out. Are you kidding? I just lost barely control and then went off. Yeah, also here. I looked at the minimap and I didn't turn left as I should have. And yeah, you can see how, like, 0.5 seconds, maybe less, of destruction. And then you don't pay attention to the track. Have some flashbacks left, but I have some advantage of the other guys, so I don't need to go crazy. And once again, man, it's so long, this race. That's why these videos are getting so long. Like, I'm doing 4-5 events total, and the video is like more than 20 minutes long. It's because these maps are so long. Finally, finish line, man. 3 minutes race. 3 minutes. It's an eternity. That's just the first. Wait. This is just the first round of the first event out of 3 total events. No, no kidding. No, wait. It's gonna be the way it can be.
Okay, we are ready to go. It's one-on-one, so it's going to get tactical. Caution, no penalties for contact.
Can't be that long. So at least I've already done this circuit once. And so I remember, like, the most critical spots. I remember them. So at least I can try to not mess up there. But man, like, each lap is like 3 minutes, and there you have like the first round, then semi-finals, then the finals, and then that's it, right? Then the event is over, I hope, because otherwise this event is gonna be eternally long. Critical part when it's very easy to lose control. Like here, I'm already doing it properly, so you can see what I mean by losing control, but it's very easy to lose control there. Probably I lost control so many times there that's why now I do it correct every time. Either. Okay, this this is quite long. Six. I went faster than the first round, but still 3 minutes long. It's an eternity.
Great drive.
And now the final. And I hope that then there are no more face-off events, because otherwise it's going to be crazy long. But at least the face-off is like on shorter circuits.
There's no advantage at the same start line, so you need to try and gain an immediate lead and stay there.
The same car I'm using, so I'm against my same power, pretty much. Too much drift. Faster than that. That's hilarious. The other guy behind a little bit of advantage from that. I can just understand that from looking at the minimap. Wasting too many flashbacks in case of the future. I have 2 more left, so. Catching up a little bit. Here, this rift always very, very good and always is useful too. Okay, I don't know what happened there, but just
it's
another very nice rift. You can see how much distance I gained with those 2 drifts. And that's why drifting is important. Last turn, I think. 1, the overall standings, and here how does the so now this is over, right? And that's already P1 in the overall face-off event. Yep, so that's more popularity, and that's already 20 minutes long video, so hope you enjoyed, and see you next episode. Bye-bye.